talk about boobs for a minute.
Yes.
I have serious boob envy. Fiona. Yes. Holy moly.
I know. Look, I've concealed them.
I really want you to get them out because you just fed Trixie and I was trying to concentrate on what you were saying, but I couldn't.
I know. Do you know what the funny thing? I've always, I mean, I developed early. So at 14, I'd always, I was like,
okay.
Yeah, in about 11. Year 8. Oh, really?
Grade 6. I got boobs in grade 6 and boy, pinged my bra.
Really?
And I was like, kill me. You might as well kill me.
No
it was so
way.
Embarrassing. It was awful.
See, well, you developed earlier than I did, but I developed and exploded. So sort of went, overnight I was a C cup as like a teenager. So I'd always sort of had, something going on there.
Right.
But since Trixie, I went up 4 cup sizes. Mm. To a J. I didn't even know you could get a J.
I didn't know you could get a J. I'm such a boob person because I don't have boobs. Like when my milk came in at the hospital, I turned around to Sam and I went, ah! And he's like, wow. Like they looked like big fake bolt-ons.
Wow.
But I still only filled out an A cup.
Really?
With all my milk in.
Wow.
I love boobs. Sam sometimes has to say to me, you can't just touch random women's boobs.
Really?
Because I'll look and I'll go, they're beautiful.
You have often touched mine over the years, so I did know that. But no, see, Katie, these are udders now.
I love them.
They're just, I mean, they're very functional. They're very heavy, though.
Yeah.
And I'm getting a sore back.
Yeah,
and I'd love a little massage. Maybe you'll give me one after this.
Probably not.
That's it. I didn't think you would. But the funny thing is, I think when you have boobs, they're not a novelty. So you actually go over them quite quickly. And in fact, all my girlfriends who similarly have an ample bosom are really
don't
over their boobs.
Bosom.
Don't want them. I thought of a reduction years ago.
Yeah, right.
Just because it was really uncomfortable. You know, I have all sorts of shoulder issues.
Do
just
you
from
really?
Yeah.
Because I used to. There used to be girls in high school that would have big boobs, and they'd go big boobs in high school, and then they'd have all back problems and stuff. And I'd envy the back problem, but maybe I shouldn't.
No, you shouldn't, because I've been a double D for a long time, and to go to a J, I thought that was bad enough. But J at the moment, this is they're heavy. See, that's the other thing. I've always had heavy boobs. I wouldn't mind if they were like balloon-like and bounced up here, but they're just, so heavy.
But they're doing an amazing job. Trixie just is feeding so beautifully.
Mm.
You just, because I think some women are so natural at breastfeeding. I wasn't. I found it so hard. I persisted.
Mm.
But 5 bouts of mastitis.
Oh, that's so unfortunate.
But you're just cruisy with it.
Yeah, it just happened. And the funny thing is, I didn't think I would be good at it, and I didn't think I'd like it because I had quite sensitive nipples.
Mm.
And I remember thinking, oh, just a little person,
latching
on, and that would be really uncomfortable. But she was put on my boob probably about 20 minutes after she was born.
Right.
And she knew what she was doing. I mean, she is amazing. She knew what she was doing, which was good because I didn't. And I've had no problem ever since.
How amazing is that first feed? Like, I remember that. I wonder if it was different for you, though, because you did have a C-section. But they put backs on me, and he whizzled himself down to it.
Oh, really?
Like a little worm. Like, they know where to go to find the milk.
Really? No.
Unbelievable.
Trixie was literally just latched on.
Yeah,
her head was like, put there, do your job. And she did it.